So today's video is about a couple guys, or actually, I'm sorry, one girl and one guy, one Thai person and one Phalang, who have never eaten at Taco Bell. So we are going to have them try Taco Bell for the first time. Yeah, I guess maybe in the States it would be uncommon for somebody to have had not had Taco Bell, but I guess for somebody who's Thai and for somebody who's from the UK, for them not to have Taco Bell is not that weird. So we're gonna order one item. We're gonna order one of each item at Taco Bell and then see what they think about the items itself. It'll be kind of interesting because one is a foreigner, but he's from the UK. And then the other one is Thai, so I don't expect the Thai person to really like it much at all. Sawadee krap! Could I try this mango on
the fish?
Yeah.
Would you like a size? Bigger one?
No, I better get a small one.
Medium, different, 15 bucks.
Yeah, okay. Aki, A-K-I?
A-K-I?
Yes.
Normal sweet or little sweet?
Normal sweet's okay.
Can I have to put some cheesecake on?
No, I'm good today.
185, huh?
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Look good. All right. Cool. Get a little umbrella. There's an umbrella inside, huh?
Yes.
Can eat or not eat?
Can eat.
Oh, really?
White chocolate.
Okay, go for go. Wow, this is good.
have it.
What's up, baby?
I think you're gonna be... I thought you were gonna be more early, so I told him to come a little bit later. So he's gonna be here in 10 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah. How was class today? You wanna try this? I'm having a mango on the beach. Try mango on the beach. No, not for you. No, I'm not going to buy you nothing because I want you to eat the food. Taco Bell. But I'll buy you a drink after Taco Bell. You late, so you cannot get angry.
I'm not late.
Hey, baby, how was class today? You not answer my first question?
Daddy, I'm not late.
Okay. You're on time, baby.
Thank you.
I don't like this kind of...
Hey, what time you wake up today?
9.
Oh, just a few minutes before I wake up. I wake up like 4 a.m., do some cleaning and work, and then I go back to bed. I don't know if you know. Yesterday I thought it was going to rain, but no rain. And then today, cloudy, but no rain.
Today
is hot. It's so hot here. Scream, everyone scream for cappuccino. Remember this used to be for KFC? KFC, the big one, right? Remember? Do you remember or not remember? Yeah, this used to be the big, big KFC. And it used to have 24-hour in delivery. Okay, after I start filming, I'm gonna send you a link down below in the information tab, and that'll be kind of the part two of the video. Another gentleman is filming and he'll do better editing, so it'll work out better if you watch his video. But he's a friend of mine and he's the owner of a pub and bar here in Thailand. But known him for a very, very long time. And he's the other gentleman, the foreign friend, the Furlong, who has never been to Taco Bell. And his cameraman will be doing the filming, and he does all the editing, so it'll work out perfect. Now it's 24-hour, or 12-hour. How do you like... How do you like your color of your hair, baby? Like when you wake up and you look in the mirror, what you think? You think good? You think so? And what your sister say, older sister?
She said,
ah, good.
She wants to go. Maybe I have to come.
a little bit. Yeah, I do. I like either one, babe. Huh? Either one, okay for me. I like both.
You cannot say you don't like
When do you have to make a payment again for your house, baby? When do you have to make pay more money for your house?
Actually, I pay every month.
Oh, you pay every month?
Yes.
$5,000?
Yes, $5,000 for every month, but I have $200,000 left.
Left.
If I pay all.
Ah, okay.
You
understand? Yes, I do.
$200,000. Yeah. This not with this.
Yeah. You want to try a dessert later, baby? They have thing called Hokkaido double vanilla cream puff. And then they have sweet purple potato cake. And then they got a thing called s'more tartlet, and then white chocolate green tea cake. Yeah, I know, we're gonna eat Taco Bell. Last time you go to Starbucks, what you drink? What you like to drink? Caramel macchiato? Caramel frappuccino? Huh? Macchiato. Phil say he's walking here now. Baby, can you wave to Phil for me? Give Phil a wave. Wave. I sent to him. Okay, cup and cup. Phil wants to save 33 cents, so he's walking instead of take the bottle. Nothing. I say Phil walking here.
How long?
He right here. His bar, you know, close, so just take him 5 minutes.
He's staying in the bar now.
Yeah.
Open already?
They open for lunch 11 o'clock.
Oh.
You know, they serve food, right?
Yes.
Yeah, they serve food. And so they open 11 o'clock.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he start maybe 10:30, get everything set up. About maybe going, well, the airplane is on the 30th, but I'm thinking about going to Bangkok maybe 29 or 28. Maybe stay close to, there's a shopping mall close to the airport called Mega Bangna. You ever hear of this? And they have an IKEA store. You know what I talk about, or no, not really. So there's a street here. Ooh, there's a Buntabon. So there's a street called Bang Na. Yeah, Bang Nang. By the Sunabun Airport. So I was thinking about getting a hotel close by. And then I need to go to IKEA in the shopping mall.
Why do you have to go to IKEA?
Look for the kitchen shelf. The shelf for the kitchen. So we can do that, maybe go 2 days before, 28, 29. And then I fly out early, number 30.
What time?
Oh, like 7 a.m. So I have to get up 3 a.m. Because I got to take a testing at the airport 1 hour before. So I think I can check in for international flight 3 hours before and then do the testing 1 hour before. So that means I have to get to the airport 3 a.m. So 3 a.m., 4, 5, 6, 7 a.m. That gives us 4 hours. But we have to get up 2 a.m. to take shower, right? Check out. So get up 2 a.m., take a shower, go to the airport, take a testing, check in luggage, maybe eat something after check-in. Have to sleep during the daytime, but maybe go stay 28 and 29 in Bangkok just so we not have to hurry. Go shopping, go eat at the mall, relax, can get a massage at the mall. You think that's going to be okay? Yeah. I thought before we can do 1 day, but then we're going to have to run and hurry too much, and it's going to be too much to do in 12 hours, because if we go leave here like 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, travel 2-3 hours to Bangkok, check in hotel, go to IKEA, go eat dinner, then we'll only get to sleep 3-5 hours. I think it's better to go for 1.5 days, so like almost two days, a bit easier. You think so? Yeah, go 28-29. Well, no, because we don't like to get up early and you have class, right? Or can you skip class?
No, if on that day I can show them not go.
What's your schedule like? You busy? You have a busy schedule? You have something you have to take care of? No? Okay, let me talk to my friend from... my friend Ray coming in from Bangkok, from London. So let me talk to Ray and find out about the schedule first. It's hard to figure this out until I talk
or
to Ray.
Come and then you go back same day.
Let me look. He's flying out on the 29th, 9:30 a.m. Let me talk with him. I'll ask him what his plan is for 28. Are you going out? Are you gonna have a, you know, I gotta find out from him. Yeah, he come in on Saturday. maybe come in Saturday. I got to talk to him tonight. When he wakes up, I don't know what time it is in London right now. Right now it is 7 a.m. in London time. So once he wake up and I talk to him, then I will know everything and then I can talk with you. It's really hard to make a plan without talking to Ray first. So let me talk to Ray and then decide. Yeah, IKEA in the mall next to our hotel, next to airport. I looked for a hotel close to the airport and close to the shopping. So going to be good.
And then how did they bring
a taxi? I'm going to take Mr. T taxi or take a Volt taxi. Uber taxi or Grab taxi.
They don't have IKEA in Tokyo.
They don't have what? No, they don't have IKEA store here in Petia, Chonburi. No IKEA in Chonburi. Only they have three, but all three in Bangkok.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Indek.
Huh?
IKEA Indek.
Yeah, we'll go to IKEA in Bangla, and then Bangla.
Bang.
Yes. What do you say? Bang? Bong? Boom? Bong?
Bangla?
Bangla? Bangla?
Bangla?
Bangla?
Bangla?
Bangla? What's up? Where's your photographer?
Where's your camera? He's in Phuket.
Oh, so you have to do your own thing.
I have to do my own thing.
Okay, let's go. Let's eat.
Let's eat.
Are you excited? Probably not.
Mildly, yeah.
Let's go! Yay! The reason why I called you was I felt like she could only eat a bite or two, and I thought, oh, maybe you would like to have some Taco Bell. But then I didn't realize you never had Taco Bell, which is just so bizarre to me.
It's not even that tough. I don't think I've ever had a taco. By the way, can we just play something else?
Yeah.
Taco Bell or Taco Bell? Taco Bell, yeah?
Yes, yes. Yes. So, years ago, when Sutini and I were dating, we would walk by the Marine Hotel and I would ask her something like, you want to go to McDonald's, or do you want to grab a burger or a fries or ice cream? And she goes, no. And I found out like 6 months later, she had never been to a McDonald's that had a burger or a french fry. So I was the first guy to do that. And so I figured, okay, let's go ahead and go to Taco Bell and see exactly what she thinks of each of the menu items.
Okay, let me just... So you're gonna go in there.
We're gonna go in there.
And you're gonna order everything.
Yes, we'll order one item of each, and we'll have both of you try your first time on each of the main menu items. And honestly, I have never been to a Taco Bell here in Thailand, so I'm not quite sure what the menu's like. I know some of the items are the same, but I'm sure that there's some items that are new or foreign to me. But we'll just order them all.
And I think she's really excited.
Yeah, just like, well, you know what's so funny is, I video called her last week when she was in Guam visiting her sister and family, and she was eating McDonald's French fries. So that's all me. The reason she likes McDonald's is because of me. When I taught her how to eat at McDonald's 8 years ago, 7 years ago, what about 7 years ago you went to McDonald's with me first time? 5 years ago?
Ah, somebody come.
Okay, you do a la carte, right? Okay, we want to do a la carte. Actually, we need some drinks, huh? So let's get... You have this big box? What is this, burrito and taco? Let's get one big box.
You want to eat here?
Yes. One big box.
Is that country taco and burrito? You want chicken or beef?
You guys want to try chicken or beef?
Chicken, I think better for the time.
Okay, chicken. Now, this is a burrito, this is a taco. Then we need one of these. Quesadilla. Is this a wrap?
Yes.
Crunch wrap? And then let's get a quesadilla chicken. Now we already have the burritos. How about this chalupa?
Yes, naked chicken taco.
Yeah, naked chicken taco. Let's get one of these. Now is this a soft taco?
Yes, soft taco.
Let's get one soft taco chicken. And then we gotta get... We gotta get nachos. So now we got one chicken soft taco, one chicken hard taco, we got the burrito, quesadilla, the wrap, the nachos, and the chalupa. Is that everything you guys have? Oh, we need to try one of these beefy. This only come in beef?
Yes,
beef. Let's try cheese. Yeah, let's try one of these. We'll try one of these. Okay. Now, do you have any tacos here that are like fish tacos? Any special for like fish tacos or shrimp tacos? Oh, sorry. I know, but I don't see it on here.
If it's not there, it ain't there.
No shrimp taco, no fish taco?
No.
Shrimp taco, fish taco?
No.
Okay, that's it. I'm ready to pay.
Anything else?
No, thank you.
May I repeat order your other big meal box?
Okay. Yes. Now, on this set, we get one drink or two drink?
One drink.
Okay, can we add two more drink? And this is for here. Kapu cup? Okay, I got change actually. Oh, I'm sorry, we're supposed to put that here.
Thank you.
Okay, cup of cup is for you. Okay. Okay, cup of cup. Is this our...
Yeah, you're okay?
Yeah.
Do you two want to sit there and I'll sit here?
Up to you.
Yeah, yeah.
Where do you want to sit, babe? Okay, you want me to sit here?
No.
Why can't I film both of you at the same time? You're going to sit on this side. When that buses? Cold, huh? Cold in here.
Now, mate. Yeah. How are you? How's your sister?
Yeah, I tell him the big news. I say, sister going to get married.
Yeah.
And
oh,
and going
good.
To go to Switzerland.
That's good news, man.
So, the date for 6 year? They date me for 6 year or 8 year?
6 year.
8 year.
6 year.
6 year. Oh, so he moved quickly. He moved quickly.
He meets you for a long
time. I know. Well, what's going on with me? I'm so slow. I don't make the move quick enough. I'm just a slow guy, you know?
So I'm not waiting for you.
What, you not wait for me?
No, no, kun, okay, man?
No. No, okay.
Okay, are you Thai?
Now, almost 7 years.
Wow!
Okay. How come his Thai so good? His Thai better than my Thai?
No, my Thai no good. I can only say bye nai.
I know about the Thai words now.
I don't know.
I said I know 8 Thai words. Feel no more. Feel no more. What's up, baby? Baby, I think you might have to hold on to the camera when I'm...
So Todd, why we brought your own cutlery?
What's up?
Why we brought your own cutlery?
Brought my own what? Cutlery?
Cutlery?
I wasn't sure if they're going to give us a knife and we got to cut all this stuff up.
Okay.
Because you guys are sharing, right? Are you excited? You don't look excited, Sutini. For Taco Bell. Woohoo! Taco Bell, Mexican food. I know, not the same as McDonald's French fries. Look at that, Taco Bell. Taco Bell is hot. Hey, look at our food being made. Yeah, it was a few years ago that they changed the kind of the format of the Taco Bells. They started doing this kind of like a window thing where you can actually see your food getting made instead of them just being hunkered in the back where you can't see what's going on. I noticed that, I think that first started coming out about 5 years ago, 4 years ago in some of the locations. Get a cup for drinks or get them later. Yay, soda! One for you. You want me to get something for you, babe?
Push
the button. Sprite?
Uh-huh.
With ice? Just a bit, Nick Noah. Nick Noah. Phil, you want some Coke syrup?
Yes, please. Yeah.
With ice?
Okay. How's that? chino. One chino, one pasta.
How's the food coming along? Is it ready? Not yet? Hard to get a right angle here. What's up, baby? Can I put my... This is good, baby. Yesterday we had Sizzler. She wanted Sizzler yesterday.
Okay.
Here.
So as soon as this starts to vibrate, our food is here. Todd, how hungry are you?
Say again?
How hungry are you?
Oh, I'm not that hungry. I just came here for you guys.
What, so you've ordered everything on the Taco Bell menu.
We'll see how much you guys like it.
And you're not hungry?
Well, no, I can eat, but I'm not like super hungry, right? I'm not ravaged. Now, this was more about bringing you guys here, especially her, but I don't think, I'd be surprised if she eats more than one item, honestly, to tell the
truth. So basically, it's all for me.
Yeah. How much do you want to eat? There's a lot of dishes tied, just, you ask him, like, you know, there's times where we would go to a kind of a wrong restaurant chain.
Yeah.
And I would ask her the first time, like, oh, how is it? She goes, oh, okay, or good. And then I kind of grill a little bit deeper if it, like, you really like it, or you just, it's okay. She's like, oh, not really, it's just okay. So then you find out, okay, she doesn't really like it. She just gives a standard answer of, oh, it's all right.
You know, Thai people are very serious about food.
Mm-hmm.
They're very serious about how they prepare food, where they eat, who they eat with. Everything has to be just right for them.
Yeah.
So it's a bit like France. France is like that.
Yeah. Yes, many times the first response from her is it's good or it's okay. But then...
Because she's been polite?
Yes.
Which is very, very cute. It's nice. It's Thai style.
Yeah.
It means she chop kun mak mak.
She's on her phone. She's not listening.
Wow. Now, my Ben Dai, Ding Dong, I think our food's coming to.
Okay.
I can see a monster bucket over there.
Ah. So your camera guy's in Phuket, what's he doing over there?
He's on a holiday.
Oh.
Doing nice. Naughty things, I think.
How many days is he going to be over there?
About a week.
Oh, nice.
Okay, she's ready. Here comes the food.
Okay, great. Thank you so much.
Everything on the Taco Bell menu.
Let's just start with the real menu first. We're gonna have to put this all over on the side here. Actually, we got this burrito we gotta take care of, so let's take care of. Oh, we got a taco. I'm gonna just cut this in half, guys. We'll give you the bigger portion. Actually, I just do that. Is that chicken? What do you think that is? It looks more like beef.
I think we ordered chicken because...
Or is that just a bean taco?
Ring Tai Po.
Okay, baby, here's a crispy taco. Crispy taco. You want some hot sauce? I don't know. It's taco. Taco.
I don't eat beef.
Huh?
I don't eat beef. This should be
ordered. Okay. I asked. Hey, is this beef or chicken?
Chicken.
Chicken.
Chicken. Yay!
I don't know. She can't have the nachos, buddy, because she doesn't eat beef. I think this might be beef here on this one. Hey, is this one chicken or beef?
Chicken.
Chicken too? Okay, great, thank you. Okay.
It's a bit spicy.
Spicy? Really? For Thai person, they say spicy. Okay. One, really bad. 10, the most amazing thing you ever eat. Which one is it? 1, 10, 5, what you think? A 5? That's not bad for a Thai person. You gave it a, huh? 7. Really? Did you hear that, Phil?
7's not bad, but yeah. She might be being Greng Chai.
That's chicken. You can only eat a little bit if you want and give to me. What's up, baby? Aloy? So, how about the burrito? What do you think?
This one better.
I know it's better. But what number do you give the chicken burrito? 5? Okay, so the crispy chicken taco, you give a 7. So, 7 for the crispy chicken taco. And then the chicken burrito, you say is 5.
So Todd, what's this?
This is the crispy chicken taco, hard shell, which Zucchini said was a 7.
Here we go. Does this come with any sauce?
Yes, there's sauces right there. You help yourself.
All right. Question is, would I rather be eating this or a big kebab on New Street in Birmingham? Hold on.
Now, I don't think Zucchini can have this one because this looks like a beefy quesadilla and she doesn't eat beef.
So this is the standard chicken taco, yeah?
Yes.
Right.
Well, crispy taco.
It's okay, but it's kind of light.
Okay, you know? And what number would you give it? Not very good, 10 the best thing you've ever had in your life?
You know, numbers is not really my subject, but okay, so it's nice, but it's tasty, but it's just not very filling. It's just like crisp.
Okay.
7, again, 7.
Oh, well, the 7's not bad, really, for a fast food restaurant.
Okay. So what's this?
That is the quesadilla. I believe it's beef, and Zucchini does not eat beef, so you'll be the only one trying that one.
Now this is a little bit like an Indian roti.
Mm-hmm.
Like a light bread with a filling.
Yeah.
So this is beef. Cheese is obviously in there.
Quesadilla.
Those Mexicans like cheese.
Now, that is beef that you're tasting, is that correct? It's not chicken, right? because she does not eat beef, so I did not give that to her.
Let's just call it meat.
Okay. Mystery meat? Yeah, that is the chicken. Oh, can we see inside? Can you open a little bit?
Yeah.
Hey, you know this taco is different than back in the States. So the chicken that we get back in the States is chopped up. This one here is like a chicken patty. So this is chicken soft taco. Aloy makmak?
Todd, what am I having here?
That is the chicken soft taco, but it's not the version that we sell in America.
So this is Thai style chicken soft taco.
Yeah.
So soft taco.
Aloy?
Okay.
You want me to have later? Okay. I guess this is all me.
This is just like a wrap, yeah?
Yes.
It's like a wrap, like
it is.
You're getting chicken, Texas chicken.
Yes, yes, exactly.
So this is the favorite thing, best thing I've eaten so far.
Oh really? And what number would you give it?
Well, about an 8, Tony.
Wow, 8 for a chicken soft taco.
Because it reminds me of the chicken wraps that you get in Texas chicken, which I really like, by the way.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Did I give you any chicken wraps when I sent you the food over? Was there any chicken wraps or were they all gone?
No, no, no.
Sorry, buddy.
Okay. So what's this?
That is the burrito. Burrito.
What's a burrito?
It's just a wrap that has rice, beans.
Rice?
Yeah.
Okay. So what meat's in here?
Chicken.
Chicken burrito.
Yeah. We got some nachos too. For
this
you
is
to
like
try.
Indian food.
Yeah.
Seriously. This is like a biryani and a wrap. Have you ever eaten biryani?
Yes, I have. You gotta realize I used to work and live in India, so I've had a lot of Indian food. Plus, in Seattle, we have a big Indian community with Microsoft and a lot of tech companies. Okay, this is the chalupa. Chicken chalupa.
Chicken chalupa.
Wow, so good, huh? Aloy? The best thing you've ever had in your life?
The, what was that again? The biryani was...
The burrito.
Burrito.
Chicken wrap burrito. Now this
I got a 7.
They call the, a 7. Now this is called the naked chicken taco, but in America they call this the chalupa. Chicken chalupa. Hey Sutini, what you give for chicken?
So this has got this is just a piece of chicken with stuff inside.
Yeah, isn't that funny?
7.
A 7? How come everything's a 7?
Oh, the last thing you...
What was your favorite? Taco? Chicken taco? Soft one or hard one?
Soft.
Soft one you like the best. Well, let me cut up some more food for you.
Mine friend.
Oh yes, you are. Now,
so this is a naked chicken. What's it called in America?
In America, it's called a chalupa.
Chalupa. I feel like I should have a big like Mexican hat on when I say that, and maybe like a donkey. Or am I going too much into stereotypical Mexican things?
Now this one here, this one is beef, so you'll be the only one eating
this
one.
You're way ahead of me here, Todd. Just slow down, man. This is chalupa. I'm still chewing on my chalupa. Todd, if for example, I was on a low carb diet, you would have this, yeah?
Yes, because the chicken is the carb itself. The one big problem with Mexican food is it's full of carbs, rice, beans, the shell. From the outside to the middle to the inside, everything is carbs. Mm. With the chalupa, you get rid of the carbs and you just have the actual protein as the actual source.
Which is what I was just saying.
Yes. Right.
Oh man.
I'm getting full now.
We can't be full yet because we got about five more items to go.
Jesus. Okay, I'm going to leave that. It's not the chalupa.
How was the chalupa,
seven
babe?
Seven and a half, man.
Seven and a half?
Yeah.
That is a cinnamon twist for dessert. I know.
Come on, come on. Yeah.
Sweet like me.
What are these, Doug?
Huh?
What are these?
Those are spicy tortilla chips.
Walker's crisps. The Mexicans have put Walker's crisps.
Let me find out. You can have the,
these are just Doritos?
Yes, Supreme Wrap. They're not, hey, you gotta understand this is fast food, so it's not gonna be anything fancy or real. This is not a high-end restaurant. This is a fast food Mexican joint. So
the Doritos are okay.
Yeah. So you gave the
Cordish Mexican, fancy Mexican stuff, they're just Doritos.
Yes.
But they're nice.
Now you said that the chalupa got the highest ranking so far.
No, for me, the sopra.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus and Mary.
Now, if you had those at, if you had those at your shop, I would buy those. Your chili is amazing, but man,
thank you.
If you had nachos like that at your store, my so friends and I would be over there.
What's this? What's this here?
That is.
I've had this already. Surely, a burrito. Is that soft?
I think it's a different version of the burrito because we had two burritos, two chicken burritos.
I'm all burritoed out, but let's go.
I'm sorry, that was the beef burrito, which she cannot eat.
That's definitely beef.
Yeah, so you're eating the beef burrito, which she was not able to eat. And what do you think? Good, no good?
I prefer it to a chicken one, but again, just a text like Indian food, really. But nice, I wouldn't lock it.
Aloy? That is the Supreme Wrap. Supreme Crunch Wrap. You don't like it? What number you give? One, no, two, three?
It tastes a lot more cheese in this.
Five? A five? You don't like it and it's only a five? That's not bad. You were saying it needs more cheese?
No, it tastes cheesier than the other one.
Oh, it does, okay. See, for me to eat these burritos, I need a little bit of hot sauce.
I'm gonna die, man. That's it. Nice knowing you. I'm gonna give Balloon Chaser the password to the channel. And it's an editor.
You're full, you can't be full. You can't eat the nachos because there's beef. Lucky you.
Okay. So, I think I gave the chicken burrito a 7.
Okay.
I'll give the beef burrito a 7.5.
Wow.
But it is quite nice, it's better than the chicken one.
Yeah.
I'm full.
Now, you know in America, more people buy beef Mexican items than they do buy chicken items. But in Thailand, it's different. Notice how half the menu is it's leaning more toward the chicken side because Thais, there's a lot of Thais who won't eat beef.
Todd, what's this?
That is the Supreme Crunch Wrap.
Can I just say, I've always been a big fan of Diana Ross and the Supremes. Motown Sam. So this is, what meat is this?
It is chicken. They put everything together. Then you know how they use those presses, like a panini press? They press that thing, and that's why you get the grill marks on the outside. You want some hot sauce with that?
Can I pass on the hot sauce?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sorry, baby, I forgot to bring the sweatshirt for you. I was too busy taking care of other things today. Like washing my own dishes and doing my own laundry because someone didn't do it for me. I got a lazy girlfriend who not do any cleaning in my house, so. You're right, but you just didn't do it yesterday or today.
So this is, this is cheesy, very cheesy.
What are you eating? Oh, you're eating the supreme chicken wrap. Okay. So, is this the best meal you've ever had in your life? Best meal you had this week?
I swear to God, if I see
another chapter,
I've got to eat this yet.
McDonald's better.
I've got to eat this yet.
Same? Really? So, this is not better than Sampam.
Right. I'm kind of giving that a 7.5 as well. Maybe a 7. Gluttony.
Did you try the cinnamon twist? What do you think about the Doritos? Just Doritos?
They're very nice. They're very nice, but they're Doritos. I'm not knocking them. Lionel Messi advertises them right. What's this? What's next?
Those are nachos.
Nachos.
And they, I would say that they would be considered loaded nachos because it has the meat, has the beans, it has the cheese sauce, has the pico de gallo, which is the chopped tomatoes, chopped onion, cilantro, has the guacamole, and has the sour cream. So basically has it all.
Okay.
Would this be a menu item you would be adding anytime in the near future at your bar?
Only because my bar is really like about my childhood and what I used to eat as a kid. And I think you need to, if you do something, you've got to do really well. I think somebody who has passion for Mexican food can make Mexican food real good.
Mm-hmm.
The whole point of this video.
So the whole, I make Mexican food, and all the Mexican food I make is not Taco Bell. None of it is Taco Bell. So when you came over to DJ the other day, a couple of weeks back, I don't know if you noticed, but I had pineapple salsa, I had fire roasted salsa, I had pico de gallo. All that stuff was scratch made.
There's nothing else, is there? Is this the last thing?
Yeah.
I can't eat anything else. So to order everything off the Taco Bell menu is about 1,000 baht.
Well, there was three additional items that were beef only. So they probably have about 16 menu items, but some of them were beef exclusive, so I did not order them. Because she doesn't eat beef. Now one of them came in a set, which was that box.
So you bought the girl to Taco Bell, but she doesn't eat beef.
Why didn't she eat chicken?
Todd, a lot of Americans have told me that you eat Taco Bell sort of late at night when you've had a few drinks.
That is true.
I can tell why.
Every single time I eat Taco Bell back in the States, I always tell myself I'm not eating Taco Bell again, so that tells you how much I think of Taco Bell. Now, when I was in high school and college and a few years outside of college, my friend David and I, we'd go out drinking and we end up in some Taco Bell drive-thru line at 3 o'clock in the morning. And between the two of us, we would spend anywhere between $20 and $40 in the drive-thru line. You gotta understand, $20 to $40 worth of Taco Bell is a lot of food. But the older I got, the more I realized I did not like Taco Bell. And honestly, there's been a bunch of times where I was hungry at 2:30 in the morning and I was unwilling to stop through the Taco Bell drive-thru line because that's how much I did not want Taco Bell.
So this, it's Doritos.
Yeah.
With some like savory stuff on it basically.
I'm not knocking it. Nachos. Has the chips, has the cheese, has the beans, the meat, the diced up tomatoes, diced up onions with the guacamole and sour cream. That is standard nachos.
No, pardon.
And when you have all those items together and you have that many, like 7-8 items on there, then they can add the word supreme. Now, if you had a basic nachos with just cheese or just meat, they just call them nachos. But whenever they add that many items, then they try to charge you more and they'll say supreme nachos.
Todd, is there a large incidence of morbid obesity in Mexico, by any chance?
Yes. So, how do I phrase this? I have a lot of Hispanic and Mexican friends, and I used to work and live in Mexico before I got transferred out to Thailand. And the one thing you'll realize is, the younger Mexicans are fairly thin, but as they get older, all that carb eating catches up to them. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people in Mexico are overweight because the diet is so heavy on carbs.
And I know that they don't go around in cars, they go around on donkeys. So the donkeys must be really strong.
Yes.
To carry these overweight Mexicans.
Now, you gotta also understand that because so many people don't want to eat carbs anymore, there's a lot of places that either do a naked taco, or what they do is they'll ask for no carbs. Like my friend in Mexico, who's still working down there, he'll basically say he'll take his on lettuce leaf. So if he can do it like a lettuce wrap,
right,
and he'll do his three tacos and he'll just say, hey, I don't want any shells, I don't want any tortillas, I just want the meat and the salad portion. Coke Zero?
Did they say just go to KFC instead?
What's up?
Just go to KFC instead.
You know what the funniest thing about KFC is? So I go to the patio orphanage. You remember how we used to go to the patio orphanage?
Absolutely.
And do some charity work? Well, I go there on every visit. Once at the beginning, once at the end, and I take them. I used to ask them every single time, where do you want to eat? And I stopped asking them that because every single time KFC. You ask them, they just say they want to eat KFC.
Everyone wants KFC.
Yeah.
McDonald's isn't big here.
And they have a thing, they think that every time I go back to the States, they think I'm eating KFC every day. And I have to tell them, in America, I haven't eaten a KFC in probably over 12 years. And so I have to explain to them, we do not eat a KFC every day.
I'm telling the Colonel on you.
Now, I'll tell you, when you came over the other day and I sent over that Texas chicken, that was the very first time I had Texas chicken. I have to say, the Texas chicken was good.
Really good.
And unfortunately, the bad thing is it's around the corner from my house. So I can see myself ordering the Texas chicken quite too often now.
I'm turning into American because I'm talking to you about Texas chicken, KFC, and Taco Bell. This is not a British expat conversation.
Now,
we just talk about how many beans are on the 99 baht breakfast.
Let me ask you a question. Taco Bell, when did it first arrive in the UK?
I have no idea. I haven't been to the UK for 15 years.
Okay.
But I saw a video the other day. Some dude walking around a place called Shepherd's Bush in London. which is in North London.
Yeah.
Sorry, West London. Everyone in North London is going to kill me. West London. And he went past the Taco Bell, so so he's there. But I'd never seen a Taco Bell in England. But I haven't been in England since.
Now, how long has Taco Bell been in Thailand? They've been in Bangkok for quite a few years, right? Mm-hmm. I want to say they've been in Bangkok for quite a few years. And during that time, on any business, as you've gone through Bangkok on a business trip or got supplies, you never once thought, oh, I want to walk into a Taco Bell and try one item. Because you know there's a many Americans.
Well, look, it's quite clear. I'm looking around. There's not many Thai people here eating this food. It's all Westerners.
Yeah. So, although they geared the menu mostly on the heavy chicken side.
Yeah.
But there's not, it's not still drawing in the Thai clientele. First of all, I think it's not cheap enough for Thais to want to spend a higher amount. I mean, they can go get Thai barbecue for $199 all you can eat. Why would they spend $149 baht on one single taco? Right? They look at the value and say, why would I want one taco that's not going to fill me up when I can have all you can eat buffet? What do you think, Sutini? Come to Taco Bell every day, one time every day for lunch?
I don't like.
You don't like? Well, not come here no more. No, I don't really like Taco Bell, to tell you the truth.
So you brought me here to Taco Bell, but you don't like it.
I brought, first of all, I knew I wanted to bring her because she says she never ate at Taco Bell. So I wanted to see her reaction. And then when I found out you never been here, I was like, how is that even possible that I run into the two only people here who have never had Taco Bell?
So, kun gin Taco Bell leo arroy mai.
Arroy, but no, not my style.
Not your style, okay. You think Thai people like?
Some people like.
There you go, and she's cooked a lot. So, Todd?
Yeah.
Can I just say, thank you for bringing me to Taco Bell.
Yeah.
You've
had your.
I am dead.
You're full from your one experience, and it'll be what? Never 10 years from now before you have Taco Bell again?
Todd, I got a whole day of work and I got to do a live stream tonight as well.
Yeah.
And I haven't had my cinnamon sticks.
Oh, you haven't had dessert yet?
No. Wow.
And you weren't a big fan of the Doritos?
Well, no, I wouldn't say I wasn't a fan, but it's like...
It's just Doritos.
It's Doritos.
Nothing
like,
jump up and down
like
about.
It's like going to a fancy restaurant in England and eating Walker's crisps. Okay. I don't.
All right. Yeah, I didn't really care for that wrap. Oops, somebody's calling me again.
Taco Bell.
Yeah, can you leave with can you leave at reception?
Right, but to be honest,
leave
nice,
with reception.
But still should be convinced.
Okay, yeah.
Couple cups. Chicken or McDonald's or Burger King or anywhere else.
Huh?
But thank you to Todd. Todd's busy. Look, he's doing the business deal as we
speak. This is Carrie, right? Carrie Delivery.
So there you go. So thank you to Todd for bringing me to Texas. No, not Texas Chicken, to Taco Bell.
To Taco Bell.